Charlotte. Okay. For all we know, that's probably our copy that we just gave away when your mama did a deep clean right before we started this book talk account.
We saw a book there that was originally bought from the dollar store, y'all, for like $1.99. And then the price they put was for like $4.99. It's like, okay, hold on, this is a leap.
You guys, we're back at it and we're about to do our favorite thing. This was very impromptu. Oh, can we go?
Okay. Let's go.
Oh, let's go. Oh my god. We're about to go thrifting at Talese. And this is the only one that's anywhere near us. They're very far and few in between. Right? But we're gonna see what we can find, right?
Oh yeah, I'm so excited. I feel really good because last time we didn't find a whole lot.
No, we did not.
I think this is the time. This is the week. The calm before the storm.
Oh gosh, yeah. I also had something to return. Books, books, and lots of books.
Should we get it?
Oh, you really want to read it again?
I feel like I want to read the series.
We just got rid of it.
I know, right?
The Lovely Bones. Have you heard of that book?
Never.
Maybe.
Yeah. Oh, look at this look.
This is a good copy. I'm gonna take this copy for myself.
How dare you? That's the first one.
Okay, so this is the one I have. So I don't have this one.
And that's the second one.
So I don't have this one.
No, you have the blue one already. But you don't have the red one.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Woo! Jackpot. Okay.
Here again.
Do you have my phone? Oh, I do have your phone.
Okay guys, so we just got back from Talese. Anyways, we just got back from Talese and we actually found a couple of books in there. So I'm going to show you that when we get home because it's in the trunk. But we picked up five books. They had four for a dollar. We picked up five books. It was like buy four, get one, the fifth one free. And obviously you pay the higher price of the books. I know some of you guys were saying you didn't realize how expensive books are. They really are. I mean, and you guys were saying that you can get books, I think in the UK, 3 for 10. I'm like, that's an amazing that's an amazing deal. However, we did notice that the prices changed. Last week I was complaining to Char. I was like, these books, like, they could be a little bit cheaper,
right? Because they're thrifting books, right?
Yeah, I think some of them were like $6.99 and stuff. Yeah. This week we went back, tell them the prices, Char.
They were like $2.99, $3.99.
Well, not most of them. Most of the ones that we like are like $3.99 and $4.99.
yeah.
We're like, what?
But still, it brought it down like $2.
Yeah.
That's great.
Basically, all the ones that we picked up were like $3.99. I think there was one that was probably a little bit more. But they were really good. So anyways, we'll do that haul when we get home. But we're actually at our local library because we've been utilizing the library. I'm currently reading the fine print through the library on ebook style and listening to audio. And so we're here to just kind of see what they have. Anyway, so we're going to go into our local library to see what we can find.
Right? Yeah. Any of our books on our TBR. We have a couple things on hold right now, right? So we're just waiting for that. But let's go.
So we're currently in the section that says new nonfiction. They got new fiction, new nonfiction, fiction for teens, kids. So kind of want to see what's here. How to restore a timeline. It's just not me. Why am I here? Why am I in this section actually? Let me see that again. Oh, it's a nice cover. So I just saw this book and I read the back of it and it sounds so interesting, guys, but I just don't think I'm gonna take it out this time. I'm gonna put it on my TBR because it just seems really interesting, but I'm such a mood reader and right now I don't think I'm in the mood to read just like a fiction. I'm still in very much in like a romance era, so I'm gonna kind of focus on that. But yeah.
Yeah. No, oh my goodness. I get it. Oh my goodness, I actually really want to read this one. Well, maybe not that one, but like.
Oh, we've been seeing this one everywhere. Charlotte's actually reading this right now, and she is so, so close to the end. I think we're going to get this one because then I'm going to continue reading it. Did you enjoy reading it on your. You enjoyed reading out of your tablet? You guys, I've never seen this book, but the cover is stunning. Oh my gosh, she is so cute and so pretty. Also have honey and spice, y'all. I'm gonna get this because I have been hearing so many reviews and I've been wanting to try it, so definitely gonna grab my hand on this. I'm here, stay here.
Okay guys, so we are back from our adventure because we went to multiple places.
We went to both Talese and the library.
That's right. We ended up going thrifting for a little bit and we tried to find some clips, so we'll probably put some b-roll in here to show you some of what we found. Today was actually a good day. One thing we did notice about our thrift store, and I don't remember if we told you, is that the prices seem to have been adjusted.
Yeah, I think they heard us last time we were there. The books there are usually like $5.99, $6.99. And
we're like, this is a lot.
Yeah, why?
Especially given that we went to that one thrift store where it was like a dollar. We came out with like brand new books that were a dollar. I'm like, this is not making much sense because some of the books at the thrift store, they're not always in perfect condition, but it doesn't even matter the condition. They're just selling them for $6.99, $7.99. They used to be like so much cheaper back in the day.
Yeah, honestly, yeah. We saw a book there that was originally bought from the dollar store, y'all, for like $1.99, yes. And then they put it, and then the price they put was for like $4.99. It's like, okay, hold on, this is a leap. This person got it at the dollar store.
And it clearly showed the sticker that it was from the dollar store for $2.99. I think it was actually for $6.99 or $5.99 or something like that. That was like for like. What is happening here?
Why?
So anyways, long story short,
We did get a bunch. We did get a nice little stack from Thrifting, and we'll show you the stack of that. But then we, but before we do that, or should we do that first?
Yeah, we should do that first.
There you go.
Thank you. Now, we got a little bit of a story. Buckle up.
Right? So, this week on Thrifting with Mom and Char, we found this. I have been really intrigued in witnessing this mystery, this mystery series. I haven't really seen a lot of book talkers or YouTubers talk about it, but I've been intrigued by it, and I really want to get, and it's gotten really good reviews, so I wanted to give it a try. I just, however, didn't want to spend full price for it, because they are pretty pricey in our bookstore. I don't remember how much we saw them for. They're like $23 here.
Yeah.
Anyway, first copy I came across in while thrifting was so beat up, so I left it behind. And then we discovered the fancy bookstore, and there I saw them for about $12, and I did end up getting one copy. I did see a bunch, but one was hardcover. Didn't want that. I grabbed the soft cover of the blue one, so I have one copy of this. But I just ended up grabbing the one for $10. How about I found this one today? Mint condition. It wasn't even red. I hope it's not because it wasn't good. Maybe someone is just cleaning off their TV. They're just cleaning off their shelf. Anyways, $4.99. I have to show you. This is living proof. $4.99.
They would have put this up for like $6.99.
$6.99 easily. And you know what? Even if they did that, it would be like deserving.
It would still.
This would be one of those that I would be like, yes, yes, and yes, because the condition is immaculate. It's like out of a bookstore. So I don't know what's going on, but yeah, I'm excited about that. Book number two, I picked this up because it was just another copy. It was just, again, mint condition. This is, I think, book number two or three.
Book number two.
It's book number two. Beautiful, beautiful condition. We already have a copy of it. Here, Charlotte. Oh, you know what? You can have
they're
that
both.
One. But they're actually both in mint condition. That's the thing.
Right? So?
We already have a copy of it. We decided we're going to read this one together. So let's see how much.
Oh, this one shows it here in the front cover.
Yes. This one I bought at the bookstore. It shows the price inside of it. Show them. It's written
$11.
Yeah.
$11.
And then today we got this one in mint condition for $4.99. So this is the tricky parts with thrifting for books. You really have to kind of do your research. The more you get out there and thrift and go all, you know, kind of all over the place, you kind of figure out things and you kind of have to strategize. We're not at the place where we are just starting off reading anymore, so we don't have to like jump on everything that we see.
Exactly.
Sometimes we wait. I passed this book up last week. They had this one, do you remember? In red hardcover.
Yeah.
And I left it because it was hardcover and it was going for, I think, $12. And I got it for $4.99. And then this week, I was able to get two of them, basically brand new, at a cheaper price than what the one was being sold for at the bookstore.
Yeah, literally.
So it's all about strategy. Once you have a book collection going and you have things to read, when you go out there, like, yes, you can scoop things up, but sometimes shop around and see so you can know where the best bookstores are, the best prices, and you can find yourself some gems. So I just wanted to put that in there. The next book that I got, this one, it was random for me. This one is called Three Little Truths, and this is the cover alone just got me with this one. The cover and just the little synopsis on the back. It was basically, what was it saying? I was trying to remember.
Like one happy street, three pretty houses,
Exactly. Just that alone. Exactly. So I'm excited. I did give this a review. This one was, it got like 3.5 or so reviews. So it's not like a 4-star, but I was like, you know what? I'm willing to give it a try. If it keeps me intrigued, your girl will keep it going. So got that one, and that was $4.99. Like I said, I don't know, but somehow, some way, whatever I said just triggered them, because I went back the next week and I'm like, price cut? What?
Yeah.
So yeah, very excited. I got this one as well. This one's called The Perfect Girlfriend. This one is one that I've seen a bunch of times. This is not the perfect like cover or any means, but it's not bad. It's all right, because
I don't know.
It's got the page, exactly. It's This one was on sale from what, Costco? Is that a Costco sticker? Maybe Costco or Indigo for $15.
Oh, yeah.
As I can see, got it for $4.99. And I saw it last week. I was going to get it at the other bookstore for 10 or 12 bucks, but I decided to just kind of pass on it. Look at it. Look at God. I came by it $5 this week. So that is what I found today at that local thrift store. And it was buy four, get one free. And Char found one for herself. She didn't see a whole lot today.
No, I didn't see a whole lot at all. But I did find The Maze Runner.
Charlotte, okay. For all we know, that's probably our copy that we just gave away when your mama did a deep clean right before we started this book talk account. Okay. We started this account and we were getting rid of some books and these guys were like, yeah, I'm not going to read that. Now that we are on book talk.
Can
now
you
that
blame me?
Now we're on BookTube and we're reading again. Yeah, my girl wants to read it.
Okay. So the thing is, we read it aloud together as a family, and honestly, I feel like I fell asleep a lot
in it. I was about to say.
There's like some magic about reading a book together that makes me fall asleep and forget like half the book, but also like it.
Let's not forget Watership Down.
Oh,
when you
my
think
goodness.
Of this Maze Runner, we read a book called Watership Down. If you guys haven't seen it, maybe Charlotte can insert a picture. Maybe we can insert like a picture right here, but the chunkiness of that book is like, yay. And we read that together. You couldn't stay asleep for this one?
Literally, I don't know, but like,
who am I kidding? I fall asleep
my
too.
Goodness,
don't worry.
Yeah, right? But I really want to just read this by myself because I find that it's sometimes it's more enjoyable when
you read it
by yourself because then you're envisioning it more like the way you want to. The characters are different in your head and things like that. So I really want to give this whole series a chance. And funnily enough, I see this book in like every thrift store.
You know,
every
like
every thrift store. I'm not gonna lie.
There are those books that you will see every time.
Yeah.
What are they? Like,
oh my goodness.
The Maze Runner.
Maze Runner,
50
Twilight.
Shades.
Come on, Twilight.
50 Shades.
Yeah.
Of Nay.
Casual Vacancy. Every single one that we go to.
Yeah, and all the all the Twilights. Yeah, there's some common ones that you see a lot.
Yeah.
And this is one of them. It's becoming more frequent because I feel like every week we see it when we go out.
Yeah, I see the whole series though. It's like people are actually giving
their whole trilogy. You saw the
whole series? I didn't see the whole series, but so usually I see all the books in Value Village.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and the quality is this good?
The quality is like, yeah, probably like the same, but it's like $6.99 there.
Yeah, Value Village is a little bit pricier
here.
Yeah,
so it's really good, you know. It's instead of just going to Value Village getting a whole series but like for more, why not get the first book for $3 less?
Exactly,
right? But
so so that is one that she's got. And then we made a quick little stop at our local library and I don't know, but I found some gems and I'm just thinking I need to read these books probably before I read my other books that we just bought, because library books are given on a time constraint. So we're going to go through it real fast because our camera is hinting that it's about to die. First book that I grabbed is Magnolia Parks. I'm jumping on Magnolia series. The cover, I wasn't sure that I really loved the cover. I was hoping that, because I think I saw another cover and I think I may have liked that one better, the original. But whatever, got the Magnolia. The next one that I grabbed is Honey and Spice, because I've heard a lot of good reviews about this. Sweet like plantain, hot like pepper. Okay, girl. Gotta give this one a go. And that's by an author that I just bought a book by too. And then I got this one, which is what Charlotte is reading right now. Guys, I got her this book for Christmas and then she wasn't sure, so we brought it back and here we are. Yeah, so, and she loves it. So
okay,
now we're gonna have to buy
that
it back.
We have to, y'all. It's actually so good. I am like, I have like 2 pages left to read. Literally 2 pages left and goodness.
And she's reading it on her actual tablet and it just seems like a fast read. So I was debating if I should do that. We'll see if I start on my tablet. I like the convenience of having the physical book.
Yeah.
But if I'm on the go, I can swish through the tablet real quick.
Exactly.
So you want to go through yours real quick since our camera battery is
is dying, y'all. It's dying. Okay. First one is Once Upon a Broken Heart. Okay, guys. I've been wanting to read this for a while. It's a YA. It's a young adult book. Actually, no spice at all. So happy about that. People have been raving about this on BookTok.
So, the cover is not given for me.
No, look, I don't like the cover at all. Like, okay, you're gonna make it a heart, but make it like a nice heart.
Yeah.
It doesn't look very pretty.
The cover is not giving. The cover is okay. Yeah. Next.
But funnily enough, so we put this on hold maybe like even 4 days ago, and it was like, you're gonna have to wait 2 weeks for this because there's only 2 copies mm-hmm. and 14 holds. We got this today, and I'm super happy about that. So.
That's really good.
Right? Next one is Better Than the Movies. Y'all, I was looking for this one and I couldn't find it, but I found it in a whole other section. Like, why would they do that to me? But I was really confused as to if this was the book. I'm like, isn't it a yellow cover?
Oh, yeah.
No, because there's two, y'all. There's one with a yellow cover, blue writing.
It's basically flipped.
This one's blue cover, yellow writing. It's so cute. Really happy about that. I started this one before online too, but I had the copy for too long and they took it away from me online. Last one is Sky Hunter by Mary Lou. I read one of hers, Legend by Mary Lou, and it was really good. I liked it a lot. And so I got this one. I've been seeing a lot of good reviews on it and I really wanted to read it.
There you go.
And
yeah,
this is it.
That's pretty much it for a little adventure. It was really fun out there, and yeah, we got books from both our library and from Thrifting. Now it's time to just organize how we're going to read them in our heads. But let us know if you guys are just obsessed with books and are kind of doing something similar. It's really nice, though, going and checking our local library these days to see what they have, because I'm pleasantly surprised that they do have some of the newer releases and stuff like that. So hope you guys enjoy this video.
Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you all so much for watching, and
we'll see you in the next one.
Bye. Bye.